الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده. أما بعد, إن شاء الله تعالى, in light of the statement of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, الدين النصيحة, الدين النصيحة, الدين النصيحة, that the religion of Islam is sincere advice, is نصيحة. In light of this hadith, إن شاء الله تعالى, we're going to try to mention some statements clarifying the stances and the aqidah of an individual who is very famous in the UK, and now due to the usage of YouTube is famous throughout the world because of his eloquence and his ability to speak well. But regardless of an individual's eloquence, regardless of an individual's ability to speak, that which is important to understand and that which is necessary to know for anyone who wishes to benefit his own self and wishes to stick firmly to the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, that path which will take him to Jannah, is that the religion is not to be taken from one who follows after his desires or one who is infected and follows after one of those paths that runs contrary to the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. And this individual is Abu Yusuf Riyad al-Haq. Abu Yusuf Riyad al-Haq. And the majority of his speeches are of somewhat of a general nature. He mentions frequently some biographical notes of individuals who are famous amongst the Muslims, the likes of the four Imams, the likes of Imam Bukhari, and he may go into some linguistic points and some general points. But to clarify the reality of this individual so that people do not become deceived and do not grow in love of this individual to the extent that they look to him for guidance in affairs of belief, we just wanted to mention some points of clarification. So, without any further ado, Abu Yusuf Riyad al-Haq, he mentioned in one of the lectures that is available online currently on YouTube, he mentioned some praises of an individual known as Muhammad Anwar Shah al-Kashmiri. Muhammad Anwar Shah al-Kashmiri, who is from the school of Deoband. And he went to great lengths speaking about his great ability and his great intelligence and memory and the fact that he was a prolific writer and the likes. And we wanted to mention this individual, what his aqidah is. The mentioned individual al-Kashmiri, he mentioned an explanation of the hadith, إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَالَ مَنْ عَادَ لِي وَلِيًّا فَقَدْ آذَنْتُهُ بِالْحَرْبِ. The statement of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, that Allah says that whoever goes against one of my awliya, then I have declared war on him. وَمَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ عَبْدِي بِشَيْءٍ أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ مِمَّا افْتَرَضْتُ عَلَيْهِ. And I have not obligated, I have not يعني left that by which my servant can draw nearer to me, that is more beloved to me than that which I have obligated upon him. Until the end of the hadith. And the end of the hadith, it mentions that the servant will not draw closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala except that yani his except that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will يعني give him guidance in all of his actions. But the wording that is mentioned here is a wording that the people of يعني وحدة الوجود, those individuals that believe that Allah Ta'ala is one with all of existence, they grab on to the apparent meaning of according to what they see in this, that this يعني that this statement indicates وحدة الوجود, the oneness of existence, as they say, that Allah Ta'ala and everything are one. And the author here, and rather the sharih, the explainer, al-Kashmiri, قلت أما كون الله جارحة للعبد في القرب بالنوافل فذلك نص الحديث. He says, as for Allah Ta'ala being a limb of the servant in his nearness due to the nawafil, the extra deeds that the servant does, then this is clear from the hadith, according to him, of course. Then he says here, ويقول بعد شرحه لهذا الحديث, and then he says after explaining this hadith, وفي الحديث لمعة إلى وحدة الوجود. And he said, this hadith has that which shines forth proving وحدة الوجود, the oneness of existence. And he said, وكان مشايخنا مولعين بتلك المسألة. And he said, our mashayikh were fully enamored with this issue. They were in love with this issue. Speaking about his teachers from Deoband. Ila zaman al-Shah Abdul Aziz. To the time of Shah, which is the Persian form of Sheikh Abdul Aziz. And he said, أما أنا فلست متشدد فيها. Then I am not one who is يعني متشدد. I'm not strict in regards to this issue. Meaning here that he doesn't يعني oppose this belief of the oneness of creation in any strong manner. And then he says, ويقول عن شرح لقول الرسول. And then he says, concerning the explanation of the statement of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam that Allah Ta'ala جعل الله الرحمة مية جزء, that Allah Ta'ala has made mercy into 100 parts, and he has withheld فأمسك عنده تسعة وتسعين جزءا, and he has held back 99 of these parts. وأنزل في الأرض جزءا واحدا من ذلك فمن ذلك يتراحم الخلق, and he has left one part of this mercy to be amongst the creation by which the creation have mercy upon each other. And والعياذ بالله الكشميري, who is this respected beloved individual to Abu Yusuf Riyad al-Haq, he says فيه رائحة وحدة الوجود. In this hadith is the fragrance of وحدة الوجود, the oneness of existence, يعني which is what the ability of what's called يعني the belief what's called pantheism. This belief in pantheism, that Allah is everywhere and everything. لأنه يدل على أن تلك الرحمة عينها جعلت بين العباد. He says, why? Because this shows that the mercy that is spoken about here, that it has been put amongst the servants, مع أنها كانت جزءا من أجزاء رحمة الرب, even though it is one of the parts of Allah Ta'ala's mercy. فما كان للرب جل مجده صارت للعباد بعينها. And he said, that which is of Allah Ta'ala, of the Lord, has now become itself amongst the servants. وَحَلَّ الْوَحْدَةُ رَحِمَ الْوَحْدَةُ الْمَذْكُورَةُ مُمْكِنَةُ أَوْ لَا وَهَلِ الْوَحْدَةُ الْمَذْكُورَةُ مُمْكِنَةٌ أَوْ لَا قَالُوا يعني به أما إنما ممكنة إلا أن الغلو فيها غلو. And he says, so is it possible that this mercy, this divine mercy, is what he's alluding to, is that it becomes part of the creation and mixed in with the creation? He says, yes, this is possible, but going to extremes in this issues is that just that, extremes. Showing what? That the man obviously believes in wahdat al-wujud, that Allah Ta'ala is part of his creation in some type of mystical sense. And this hadith is agreed upon by the scholars that the meaning of it is not that the servant becomes part of Allah, wal-ayyadu billah, but rather that his limbs follow after that which Allah Ta'ala is pleased with. وهذا معنى ذكره الكشميري نفسه. And الكشميري himself, he mentioned that the scholars explain this hadith in this fashion. Just as Al-Hafiz ibn Hajar, he said about this hadith, وَعَلَى الْأَوْجُهُ كُلُّهَا فَلَا مُتَمَسَّكْ فِيهِ. He said, no matter how this hadith is explained in any proper fashion, there is nothing for the people that believe in the oneness of creation, that Allah is one with his creator, creation rather, there is nothing for them to grab hold on. وَلَا الْقَائِلِينَ بِوَحْدَةِ الْوُجُودِ. Nor those people who believe in the oneness of existence. لِقَوْلِهِ فِي بَقِيَّةِ الْحَدِيثِ وَلَئِنْ سَأَلَنِي وَلَئِنْ اسْتَعَاذَنِي. Why? Because in the hadith itself we find, and if he were to ask me, if he were to seek help from me, and this is clearly refuting the people that have this belief that this hadith, the hadith of this Qudsi hadith, which is found in the 40 hadith of Imam An-Nawawi, that this hadith has some type of indication of wahdat al-wujud. And also we have يعني, the statement of Ibn Taymiyyah. He says, وَهَذَا الْحَدِيثِ يَحْتَجُ بِهِ أَهْلُ الْوَحْدَةِ وَهُوَ حُجَّةٌ عَلَيْهِمْ. He says, the people who believe in the oneness of existence, the followers of Ibn Arabi, they use this as a proof, and in truth this hadith is a proof against them. مِنْ وُجُوهٍ كَثِيرًا. In many ways. مِنْهَا أَنُّهُ قَالَ